Hello everyone, this is the lecture number 33 of the lecture series of Naval Architecture made for MEO examination. In this lecture, we will continue with the longitudinal stability of the ship. Specifically, I am going to start discussion on basics of the trim. First of all, try to understand what is the meaning of a trim. Trim means difference in the forward as well as the after draft of the ship. If you remember, in a transverse stability of the ship, the inclination of the ship in a transverse view is given in terms of an angle theta, and that inclination we have called with angle of a list. But in case of a longitudinal stability, when you see the ship in a profile view, you will find there is an inclination of the ship in profile view about the y-axis. That inclination we are not calling with some angle, we will call the difference between the forward draft and the after draft, that is the trim. So there are three conditions here regarding the trim. If the forward draft of the ship and the after draft of the ship is the same, then we will call it as an even keel condition. If the forward draft of the ship is greater than the after draft of the ship, then we will call this ship is having trim by bow condition. The third condition is, if the after draft is greater than the forward draft, then we will call this condition trim by stern. In this case, I have taken the example of the ship as a barge, or you can say boxer ship vessel. In this case, if you find that the ship is going to trim about some point, that point we are calling as a center of flotation. If you see the ship in a profile view, the ship is going to start oscillating about the center of flotation only. Now, what is the meaning of a center of flotation? Center of flotation is the centroid of the water plane area. So, to understand this concept, let's take again a box ship vessel. The ship draft at the forward and after draft is the same. This is the profile view of the ship. I am looking same ship from the top view, and this is the water plane at this draft. So if you see, the centroid of this water plane is coming at the intersection point of the midship as well as the center line of the ship. As this is a box ship vessel, it will be exactly at the midship. But for the actual ship, it won't be at the midship. There might be chances that it may go forward or it may go aft of the midship. Now, to understand the concept of the center of flotation, we will take one small animation. You will come to know that what is the meaning of a center of flotation. So again, I am going to take as a box ship vessel, and as I told, the center of flotation in case of a box ship vessel, it will be at this location only. It will be always at the midship. In a profile view, if you see perpendicular to the screen, line passing through this point, that is this axis which I have shown in a top view. If you see the same ship when it is going to oscillate, how it will look like. So this is the one of the small animation you can see here. The ship is going to oscillate about the center of flotation. As this is a box ship vessel, the center of flotation is at the midship only. We will see the three different conditions of the addition of the cargo on the ship. So first condition is, cargo is added on the ship at the center of flotation location. The second condition is, cargo is already on board and we are shifting the cargo wherever you want on the deck. The third condition, we are adding the cargo on the deck and we are shifting wherever you want. So after all the three operations, we have to see that at the end of each operation, what will be the new draft, what will be the change in the trim in the ship. So try to understand the concept one by one. The first condition is we are adding the cargo on the ship. Specifically, I am adding the cargo at the location of a center of flotation. You can see here what we have done. We have taken the cargo from the outside and that I have kept above the center of flotation location. So you found that there will be an increment in the draft at the forward and at the aft. It is interesting here that increment in the draft at the forward and the aft is the same. So this condition we are calling as a parallel sinkage or bodily sinkage. So the new draft, if you want to find out that new draft, let's call as a D2, that is equal to D1 plus the increment in the draft because of the parallel sinkage, let's call it is X. So the new draft is a D2 is equal to D1 plus X. Now the second condition is the cargo is already on board or it is already on the deck, that is also at the center of flotation. And I am shifting the cargo at the forward of the ship. So here try to analyze the draft at the forward and the draft at the aft after this operation. If you see here, there will be an increment in the draft at the forward. Let's call that is Y. And there will be a decrement in the draft at the aft, that is X. So for the addition of the cargo at the aft, let's call it plus Y, and for the decrement in the draft at the aft, that is called as a minus X. So the new draft, if you want to calculate, that will be new draft is equal to D at the aft old minus this X, that is the decrement in the draft at the aft. In the same way, if you want to find out the draft at the forward, DF is equal to D forward initial plus Y, there will be an increment in the draft at the forward. The most important and the interesting which you have to understand here, the draft at the location of the center of flotation before the operation of the shifting and after the operation of the shifting, it will be remains the same. You will not find here there is any parallel sinkage. The before the operation and after the operation, the draft at the location of the center of flotation is remains same. The third condition is cargo is added on the ship at the center of flotation location and shifted forward of the ship. In this case, you will find that when you added the cargo at the location of the center of flotation, there will be a parallel sinkage and there will be an increment in the draft at the forward as well as at the aft. Both are same. Let's call that is X. Now you are shifting the cargo wherever you want. In this case, I am shifting the cargo at the forward. So when you are shifting the cargo at the forward, there will be a draft increases, let's call that is a Z, and there will be a draft decreases at aft, that is a minus Y. Then if I ask what is the new draft at the forward, so you can write D new is equal to D old plus parallel sinkage plus Z because of the change in the trim. In the same way, if you want to calculate the draft at the aft, new is equal to draft at the aft old plus parallel sinkage minus the change of the draft because of the trim, that is Y. So like this you can calculate the draft at the forward and the draft at the aft when you have done this operation. The most and important interesting thing you can find here, the draft at the center of flotation location before the operation and after the operation, it will be always different. For example, draft at the center of flotation location new is equal to draft at the center of rotation plus the parallel sinkage x. The new draft at the location of center of rotation will be draft at the center of rotation new is equal to draft at the center of rotation old plus the increment in the draft, or that is the parallel sinkage. Now we have seen all the three conditions and we have seen how the draft at the forward and the draft at the aft is going to change because of addition, removal or shifting the cargo within the ship. Now we will do some calculations how to find out the new draft at the forward and at the aft. To understand this, let's consider the ship is there in the even keel condition. There is a cargo present on the ship and this cargo is a part of the ship only. Now what I am going to do now, I am shifting this cargo at the aft of the center of rotation location. When the cargo is shifted behind the center of rotation location, what will happen? There will be an increment in the draft at the aft, that is x, and there will be a decrement in the draft at forward, that is y. So you can see here WL is the old water line and L1 is the new water line. So what I am going to do now, from the W1 I am going to put one dotted line which is a parallel to the WL. So whatever the increment in the draft is there at the aft, that is x, same thing you can write here because both are parallel to each other, x. Now what we have discussed in the earlier slide, what is a trim? Trim is the difference between the forward draft and the aft draft. In this case, the new draft at the aft is A and the new draft at the forward is F. Now if you see here, if you just pass the line parallel to the WL, this dotted line passing through W1, this line and the keel line both are parallel to each other. So if this is A, this will be also A only. Then what is the trim? That is A minus F. So this total A minus F, we can write X plus Y. And that is equal to the trim. So if you want to write the trim equation in terms of an increment and the decrement in the draft, that you can write trim is equal to X plus Y. This is the one equation with us. Now there are two unknowns here. It means that we need two equations. So this is one of the equation. We need to generate one more equation from this same figure. Now to create one more equation, we are going to see here two triangles, triangle ABF and another triangle is a triangle ACD. By using the similar triangle method, I am going to write the equation like this. The opposite side in the triangle ABF is X divided by the hypotenuse, that is L, is equal to, if you see the triangle ACD, the opposite side is X plus Y, that is a trim, divided by the hypotenuse, that is the total length of the ship. So like this you can generate the second equation. So you have now two equations. The first equation is a trim is equal to X plus Y, and the second equation is X by L is equal to T by capital L, that is the equation 2. So if you have a two equation, two unknowns, you can easily find out the increment and the decrement in the draft. Now what is this L? L is the distance of a center of rotation from the aft. Let's call for the simplicity LA. Capital L is the length of the ship. T T is the trim, X and Y is the increment and the decrement in the draft at the aft and the forward respectively. Now out of these equations, trim is known to us by some way, we will do the numerical, you will come to know that. LA is known to us and capital L is known to us. So everything is known, X and Y is unknown, you can easily find out the value of X and Y. Now before starting the numerical, you need to understand two more concepts, that is MCTC. What is MCTC? That is movement to change the trim 1 cm. It means for a particular ship at a particular draft, how much movement is required to trim the ship by 1 cm. That is called as MCTC. Sometimes we will call it as a MCT 1 cm. So for this we have a formula is given here. MCTC or MCT 1 cm is equal to W into GML divided by 100 into L. W is a vessel's displacement always in a tons. GML is a longitudinal metacentric height always in the meters. L is the length of the ship always in the meters. The second point, that is a TPC, it is tons per centimeter immersion. What is the meaning of this? For a particular ship at a particular draft, how much amount of the cargo is required to keep on the ship so that you will get 1 cm increment in the draft. In opposite way also you can understand how much amount of the cargo we have to remove from the ship so that you will get 1 cm rise or the decrement in the draft. How to calculate this? TPC is equal to the water plane area into the density of the fluid where it is floating divided by 100. I hope all of you understood the theory which we have studied related to the trim and how to calculate the trim, what are the different conditions will be there in case of a trim, that all the things we have seen in today's lecture. In the next lecture we will do few numericals. You will definitely understand the whole thing which we have studied in today's class. Thank you very much.